My son played very serious soccer when he was younger. And at one point, he got a condition called Osgood-Schlatter's, which is essentially something that happens when you're athletic and you grow. He couldn't walk. So we went to the pediatrician, who pushed on his knee, he screamed, and the pediatrician said, he's got Osgood-Schlatter's. Wait several weeks, he'll get better. So we waited like 2 days, and then someone told us that we should go to see a specialist. So we went into MGH to see a specialist. The specialist pushed on his knee in the exact right place. My son screamed. The specialist said, he has Osgood-Schlatter's. But maybe we should get an MRI to make sure nothing else is going on. So we took him out to the MRI machine up on Route 128. He got the MRI. We got the image. We went back to the specialist. The specialist looked at the image, and the specialist said, he has Osgood-Schlatter's. Everything else is fine. Wait a few weeks, and he'll get better. So we waited a bit longer, and his soccer coach said, you need to go see the sports medicine doctor at Children's. So we took him in to the sports medicine doctor. The sports medicine doctor pressed on his knee. He screamed. The sports medicine doctor said, he is Osgood-Schlatter's. Wait a few weeks, and he'll be better. But by now, we were kind of in a few weeks anyway. We only had to wait a little bit longer, and true enough, a few weeks later, he was actually better and all was good. But all that consumption past the first pediatrician visit, the specialist visit, the MRI, the second specialist visit, the visit to the sports medicine person, all those things were probably visits we might not have done had we actually had to pay. So all of that consumption probably would fit under the category of moral hazard, things that we did because it was free.